this sort of tool has been at our disposal for quite a while, but inside of our agency, we've been using it a little bit more recently and have been pretty excited about the correlation we found between ads that we get ticking the boxes in the ad relevance diagnostics and being able to get the cost per click down and scale the ads and have more success. So what is it? It's essentially a framework that Facebook provides to us in our reporting columns to determine whether or not our ads are perceived as high quality, engaging to the audience. And then once folks go and click on the ad, whether or not they're actually converting at a high enough rate on the website. So the way you can actually use this in your ad account, let's get into that. That's probably what you want to know. In your reporting columns at the ad level, you can pull up quality ranking, engagement rate ranking, and conversion rate ranking. And in each of those, for each ad that has at least 500 impressions, you'll get a rating from Facebook, which will either be above average, which is great, average, which is okay. And then there's a few different tiers of below average. They let you know, hey, you're in the bottom 30%, you're in the bottom 20%. You might even say you're in the bottom 10%, which is basically disastrous. For each of these, now there's a link, which I'll put in the chat here, which provides a really useful sort of chart for you to look at that shows you, you know, what do I do if my quality ranking is low, but my engagement ranking and my conversion ranking are good? And it will tell you, for example, in that instance, improve the quality of your creative assets or target an audience more likely to perceive the ad as high quality. And then it gives you another link in which you can go and find out what characteristics Facebook actually uses to determine if an ad is high quality or not. So it would take me hours to go through and explain all the different things that you can access and insights that you can access through here. But here are the important things I think you need to know. Number one, Facebook tells us if your ads are performing, don't worry about it. It's kind of like we always say with Learning Limited, right? Is it good to leave Learning Limited? Sure, that's great if you can do that, if you have the budget. If you're getting results, should you be looking at Learning Limited and be really, really worried about how to get past that? No, you shouldn't. So if your ads are working, don't worry about it. That's the first thing that I thought was really interesting when I dug into the documentation. The second thing was getting one of the diagnostics from below average to average is going to be more meaningful than getting one from average to above average. So in other words, don't lose sleep if you're getting average. Average is good. It's going to be a lot more meaningful if you've got one that's below average and you troubleshoot why that is the case and turn that around. So if you get average, average, average in these three columns, chances are that's a pretty good ad and you should be getting good traction. But the types of things that this can uncover for you is like, and it really helps actually just, you know, go all the way back to like the very, very basics of running Facebook ads is like, what makes for a good ad? And this should hopefully just sort of really set that in. Quality, engagement, and conversion. Is it a good ad that has good creative that doesn't stick out to people in their newsfeed? Or is it like ugly text all over the place and clunky and clickbaity? That's number one. Facebook wants high quality ads. Second thing is engagement. Are you cleverly putting questions into your copy? Are you making a statement that maybe some people are going to feel strongly about one way or the other and they're going to leave comments? Facebook wants posts that people engage with because engagement's a good thing for Facebook, right? And then lastly, if you're sending people to, in the case of a Shopify store, you're sending them to a product page to hopefully order the product, or maybe you're sending them to a landing page to get your free PDF download. At what rate are people doing that? Because if you send people to a landing page to a product page to buy a product and absolutely none of them do so, that tells Facebook that your landing page, your product page kind of sucks. All these consumers went there, none of them bought. That's not a very fulfilling experience. So the conversion rate comes back to Facebook and Facebook said, oh, people are converting when they hit this landing page. You'll see your CPMs go down. It will put your ads in front of more qualified audiences. Your conversion rate on the website will go up in turn. And this whole thing starts feeding back into itself. So the CPMs go down, the quality of the audience goes up. More social proof gets on your ads because your CPMs went down and it got in front of more people and it was engaging. So visit the link in the chat there. Just Google Facebook ad relevance diagnostics if you're watching this on replay. It should be the first link for you. Dive into that. It's really worth diving into. It can help you get your ads. It'll help point out what it is about your ads that isn't working. And I've had a couple of people who I've talked to about this, and we've gone through with this in mind, realized that their copy was clickbaity and their $40 CPMs had to do with the fact that their quality ranking was in the basement because of that. So it's just one example, but time well spent, dig into that. And that will help you understand how to make your ads better.